I define excellence, so my definition of excellence is pretty much anything that you have mastered, be it if it's in a relationship, if it's life, if it's work, anything where you have potentially worked and had goals in any situation of the things that you wanted to achieve and you've mastered it. That's excellence. It's like the highest level. My name is Sabrina Seoul, and that's Seoul as in Seoul, Korea. And a lot of people, they really don't know where I got my name from. And I just want to say that I was born in Seoul, Korea a long time ago. And my culture and where I came from, really, I keep that very close and dear to my heart. I literally have my whole back tattooed of nothing but Korean everything. And so that's my introduction to me and who I am and where I got my name from. And I'm a fashion designer. I design clothing and I do some photography on the side. I love the photography portion of when my fashions come into play, because I feel like that I can catch the essence of the clothing. I know my vision, and I know if I'm doing the photography, it's gonna come out exactly how I want it to. And also too, I have a girls or kids, yes, girls clothing line, and it's Sadorables, and that's named after my daughter, Sadora. So I have Sabrina Seoul Designs, I do some Sabrina Seoul Photography and Sadorables for my daughter's line. So I started designing clothes in 2002. And I started designing for so many different people, so many different aspects in life. I was in the entertainment field at the time, and the clothes that I was just making was absolutely insane, but it was so fun. And I actually started sewing because I needed the money at the time. You know, it was a point in my life where I kind of was homeless, and you know, I didn't have a pot to piss in and a window to throw it out of, honey. But you know, I had to make do, and I had to figure it out, and that's exactly what I did. I'm into some pageants. Didn't have any money to enter the pageants, but I knew that I wanted to model. I modeled for 10 years and I made my clothes for the pageants. And then one thing led to another. And then that's how my business started. I took a break from sewing for a few years just because I was tired at that point. I just was tired. I was like, I don't want to deal with the business. It kind of just, it stressed me out. It just wasn't fun anymore, you know? And what happened was, after, you know, time had gone on, I'd gotten pregnant and I was about to be a mommy. And once my daughter got here, when she was about 9 months old, and because I always had that passion that I wanted to design and make clothes, when my daughter got here, I made her some clothing and we literally got dressed up. We went to the mall, she had her little leggings on, and I made me some matching leggings, and people loved us. They were like, oh my God, where'd you get those leggings from? She's so cute, I want a pair. And that's how my business started back up. So my business started back up with Sadorables, and that was in 2013. The women's part of it started after I felt uncomfortable about putting a little girl's tag named Sadorables in a grown woman's pair of leggings. So I was like, oh my God, this is a whole nother business that I'm about to start, and now it's a women's line. And I really had to ask myself, did I want to go down this path? Obviously I did. last year, I said to myself, no, about 2 years ago, I said to myself, I really want to take this to the next level. This is something that I really enjoy doing. I'm very passionate about it. I enjoy it. It makes me happy. I don't mind losing sleep or money over my businesses. And I went to DC Fashion Week, shout out to Ian. I went to DC Fashion Week and it was for, I think, the spring fashion show. And I remember going there and sitting down and seeing the models and seeing all the different clothing, the beautiful clothes come down the runways and then the designers following after them. I knew and I said to myself, one day that's gonna be me. My clothes are gonna be on the runway. And fall of 2019, the beginning of 2019, it was for the fall winter collection. I submitted my information to DC Fashion Week and I got accepted. So that was, I mean, I don't know how else anyone would feel about it, or all I know is I just felt like that was a huge accomplishment for me. It was something that I set out to do. I had been preparing for it for years, and I did it. And it was one of the best things that I could have done because it pushed me to take me, my clothes, my business to the next level. And I'm so grateful that I had that opportunity to do that. And let me tell you something, I am self-taught. Like, I did not go to school for this. No one taught me how to. I remember the first sewing machine I ever bought was from the Goodwill, and it was $20. I did not know how to thread that thing. I went to the sewing machine, I was like, how do you put the thread through the needle and make the thing come through the bobbin? How do you do it? And the lady at the fabric store was like, well, honey, all you gotta do is press the foot or just turn the wheel. I had no idea. Like, I didn't go to school, like no one taught me. I literally watched YouTube videos, hours and hours of YouTube video, and I paid attention. And I learned by trial and error. So I decided to find, and I do not know how to draw at all, but I decided to finally do some sketches. I printed out like the women figures from like online. I went to YouTube and, you know, I figured out how to draw sketches for fashion designs. And that's what I did. And I literally drew out some pieces and I sent them over to a manufacturer in another country, and I had my first piece in production. When I got that piece, when I received that piece, I started crying. I feel like I'm about to cry right now just talking about it. But I started crying because it was, you know, it was very emotional for me because I think about, like, I never forget, like, where I came from. You know, I never have forgotten where I started. You know what I'm saying? And to get to where I am right now through all the trials and tribulations and the challenges and the no's and the disappointments and just dealing with life and this COVID and, you know, salmonella. I mean, you just, you know, it's life sometimes really does catch up to you. And, you know, some people stop, some people don't even start, you know, and it's like you deal with all the things that life is thrown at you. And I just feel like with everything that I've been through in my life, I can honestly say at this point, it prepared me to be exactly where I am. Because I make all my videos, I do all my photo shoots, I keep everything in-house. After the video is shot, I go home and I edit them. After the pictures are taken, I go home and I do the editing for the pictures. After that, I market, I pay for ads, you know? I mean, I do what I have to do, and then guess what? I have to stop, and I have to go home, and I have to sew, or stop whatever else I'm doing, and then I have to stop and sew the pieces that I've actually gotten in order. But guess what? I'm a single mom. I have to stop and help with homework. I have dishes. I have to wash clothes. I have to make sure, you know, my parents are okay. Like, I'm just a real person out here trying to make it like every other entrepreneur. And I really don't think that people understand what we go through to try to just make our dreams come true, you know? And it's just the things that we're passionate about. And I think when people realize the extent and the levels that we go to make these things happen, I think people would respect us a little bit more. But you can be, I have more pieces coming. So I am doing a series, I'm doing four series, and the series have parts. So series one is based off of a black leather jacket that I did get manufactured, and the four different parts that I have with the series, the parts are based around this black leather jacket that I sketched out, got manufactured and designed and made into something tangible. So each part will be based around this leather jacket, and then the next series, which is series two, is going to be another jacket, series three, another jacket, series four, a different jacket. And each jacket or each series will have its own part. So I'm just excited to show you like what I have in store. This is something different for me. So I have no idea what I'm doing, but I'm doing it and I'm having fun along the way. So let's see what happens. I think it's gonna be pretty amazing though. So I just wanna conclude by saying, like, don't ever give up on your dreams. Get off of social media. You know what I mean? Social media is one of the things that stops so many people from actually, you know how many times I have sat in my room and I say, you know what, I'm gonna start sewing at 8 o'clock, and I will get on social media. Social media is such a distraction because it'd be like 9:30, 10 o'clock, and I'm still trolling through social media. Like, wait a minute, I stopped what I was supposed to be doing, or I didn't even start it because I'm on social media. And then, you know, you see like this lifestyle that, you know, people put up, and it kind of makes you feel like, dang, I don't think I can do that. Like, it makes you have doubts, you know. The family members can make you have doubts, you know. You not having enough money can make you have some doubts. You know, all I say is, like I said, I started with a $20 sewing machine from the Goodwill. My fabric was on the clearance rack or in the clearance bin for 99 cents a yard. And that's how I started. And with that $20 sewing machine and with that 99 cent fabric, I literally had someone come up to me and say, oh my God, that's so cute. I want one, you know? And I had no idea about business. And I asked her, I said, well, how much do I charge you? She's like, I don't know, just charge me something. And I literally had my first sale from a $20 sewing machine with 99 cent fabric. So take all those excuses, throw them out the window. It's no excuse. Just, you have to be true to what you really want to do. That's the main thing. Don't let nobody stop you. The only person that's stopping you is you. And that's facts. Like, look at me. Like, look how fabulous I look. Look fabulous. I made this skirt. I made this shirt, and I actually now I am adding fedora hats to my line. I'm kind of spicing them up a little bit with pins and ribbons and stuff like that. I don't have one on today just because I felt like it would have been too much for this fabulous outfit. But you know, just to be able to get up, get dressed, go somewhere and have on something that I've made, like, how cool is that? You know, and it's like you think about how hard it is when you first begin, but then it's like when you get here, you're like, oh my God, I got there. And then when you get here, you're like, I can't believe I made it this far. And then when you get here, you're like, shoot, I'm chilling. But no one ever knows that you started here and everything that it took for you to get up here. But understand, if it's worth it, it won't be easy. If it's easy, it will not be worth it. And you gotta get out there, you have to advertise, you have to market yourself, because people can't and they will not support you if they don't know you exist. So that's very, very important. But just stay true to you, stay true to what you believe, and love you. Don't forget to love you and love what you're doing in the process. And I'm sure everything will be A-okay. Hey, what's up? It's your girl, Sabrina Seoul, and I have been stamped by Raleigh Marketing. Raleigh Marketing is the one-stop shop for your brand.